Hi guys, you're welcome. Thanks for clicking. So this man made a statement that he saw more than 20 mistakes in the Quran. And this was Dr. Zakir Naik's response to it. Let's check it out.
Dr. Zakir, you said there isn't any mistake in Quran. I see more than 20 mistakes in Arabic grammar. And I will tell you some of them. إن الذين آمنوا والذين هادوا والصابئون. He said in Baqarah and Hajj, إن الذين آمنوا والذين هادوا والصابئين. Which is right, الصابئون or الصابئين? Number two.
Brother, one question one at question. A time.
Yeah, but at the same thing, he said in Surah Taha 63. إن هذان لساحران. Mistake. إن هذين لساحران. Can you explain that? And there is more than that mistakes.
Brother will allow you only the one. First part of the question. The second part will not allow because we have stated we'll allow okay. One question at a time so others get a chance to.
Okay.
The brother has asked a very good question. I would like to be more concordant and agreeing. He has mentioned all 20 grammatical points. And the book is referring to by Abdul Fadi. Abdul Fadi, correct? Is the Quran infallible? I can see some things. Yeah. Alhamdulillah, my side is good. I will answer all 20 together. Because I've read the book. I'll answer all 20, inshallah. Inshallah. Point number one to be noted that all Arabic grammar is taken from the Quran. Quran was the highest Arabic book, a book which has the maximum level of highest literature. All the Arabic grammar has been derived from the Quran. Quran is the textbook of grammar. Since Quran is the textbook of grammar and all the grammar is derived from the Quran can never have a mistake. Point number one. Point number two, it is like, you know, taking a ruler and the ruler is there, has a measurement and you're saying the measurement is wrong. It sounds illogical. Point number two, in the different tribes of Arabia, and you know Arabic, and Dr. William Campbell also will agree with me, in different Arabic tribes, the grammar keeps on changing. In some Arabic tribe, the word is feminine, the same word is even masculine in the other tribes of Arabia. In different tribes, the grammar keeps on changing. Even the gender keeps on changing. So will you check Quran with that faulty grammar? No. And furthermore, the eloquence of Quran is so high. It's so high, it is far superior. And you know, there are various books on the internet. You go, 12 grammatical mistake, 21 grammatical mistake, Abdul Fadi, 20 grammatical mistake. Do you think the Christian people took out these mistakes? Who took out these mistakes? Do you know who took out? The Muslims. The Muslim scholars like Zamakhshari, what they did, that the Quran grammar is so high that it goes against the conventional use of the Arabic. The Quran grammar is so high, to prove the Quranic grammar was high, they gave examples. And I'll give you a couple of examples which will answer all these 20 questions. They give the example, like read in the Quran, it says that the people of Lut, alayhi salam, they rejected all the messengers. They rejected the messenger that's mentioned. Dr. William Campbell said, the people of Noah, they rejected the messengers. We know from history that there was only one messenger sent to them. So it has a grammatical mistake. Quran should have said, the people rejected the messenger, not messengers. I agree with you. With layman grammar like how you and I know, it may be a mistake. But if you read the books written by Arabs, what is the beauty of the Quran? The beauty of the Quran is, why does the Quran refer messengers instead of messenger? You know why? Because we know that the basic message of all the messengers was same. That there is one God. About Tawheed. About Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By mentioning the people of Lut alayhi salam, the people of Noah rejected the messenger. It says by rejecting Lut alayhi salam, they are indirectly rejecting all the messengers. See the beauty, see the eloquence, alhamdulillah. You may think it's a mistake. It's not a mistake. Similarly, people like Anush Saroj says that Quran says kun fayakun, be and it is. It should be kun fakana, be and it was. Agreed. Past tense is kun fakana in Arabic. It's not kun fayakun, but the kun fayakun is more superior. It says Allah, it was, it is, and can do. Past, present, and future.
Thank you, Dr. Naik.
Okay, I think the grammatic error the man was talking about is Quran talking in the past tense like it was. You know, instead of saying, okay, Jesus is Lord. And say, probably say, okay, and maybe it is written like Jesus was Lord. Or God was. Or instead of saying God is mighty. And maybe the Quran they wrote God was mighty. So that is to say, they said it's a grammatical error because you cannot talk about somebody or your Allah that is still in existence as past tense, that why don't they refer to all these things in the present, even though there are some explanations I didn't get because I'm not conversant with those things he was saying from the Quran, but I could understand and I could get the past tense, you know, issue, the past tense, you know, issue that he discussed. So he said, even though it's not written in the present tense, most of the words written about Allah was not written in the present tense, doesn't mean it's a grammatical error. That is, it's being written in the past is trying to indicate that, you know, Allah is this today, tomorrow, and today. Allah was this yesterday, it will be this today, and it will be that tomorrow. So it goes on and on like that. So that is not an error, even though this explanation was kind of short because I wanted to understand more about it, because the man was quoting some verses in Arabic and I'm not conversant with the Arabic words, so all those other ones I couldn't get or understand, but I understood getting to the end of the video when Zakina explained why things are written that way in the Quran. Wow, this was so beautiful to watch. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.